All right. So the story I feel like sharing right now is, gosh, damn. Do you remember about that one girl that I had told you about a long time ago when I was at, like, when I first got to high school? What's that girl name? We gonna call this girl A, right? We're gonna call her girl A. This is my first girl that I ever had a crush on. All right. So girl A. So? Julius, we're saving names. Okay. So we'll refer her by her last name. We'll refer her by Tyler. Okay. So Tyler, at this situation, she
is a nigger.
Told a football player in one of our classes that she liked me. I was sitting there drawing, minding my own business, and I think this nigga, he was like, "Who you like in class?" Because you know he was kind of stupid. So he was like, he was one of them big jock types that really like didn't pay attention in class.
Jesus Christ.
But he was built. He was built, you know. So you ain't even gonna talk to him any kind of way. So he clearly liked her. So he asked her who she liked, and she pointed me out, and I took that and I ran with it. So I think I tried talking to her, but you know, the typical nervous nigga don't really say too much. So like, I only talked to her whenever I seen her, and I gave her awkward sideways hugs in the hallway. And every time I had the courage, any time I had the chance, bro, to advance with her, this nigga Taram pop up. He just materialized like Goku did, with instant, for no fucking reason, with instant transmission. Then she walks off. So I don't know if she didn't tell me. I don't know if she was leading me on the entire time or not, just to save my feelings or what. Cause it got to the point where I don't know if she lost interest or what. I think later on,
he was being soft.
I was super soft. I didn't know
soft ass nigga.
I didn't know how to talk to no chicks back then.
But you should have said it. Tyler,
so different when Tyler, was completely different from you, dude.
Because you were a hoe.
You was so much like. I am not. I was sitting there.
Ratchet, I was a nerd too, and I had enough confidence to be like, whore. Ratchet, you had everything lined up for you, though. You knew off the jump that she liked you. That should have gave you more than enough. That should have been all your spirit bomb. She
you gotta realize that I was the nerdy type that didn't talk to nobody like that.
Bullets and you have the gun. All you had to do was cock it. Ratchet, she pointed at you. She gave you the bullets, the clip. You already had the gun. All you had to do was cock it, aim, and fire, my nigga. And that nigga
but you realize, took the gun from you young,
and
bro.
Fired.
I ain't never talked. You know how many women
did some stupid shit like that, bro?
No, there was a bunch of times where my cousins and them and my uncle, like when I was like 15 or 14, they were like, "Why you get no pussy yet, nigga? Nigga, I want to play San Andreas. Why is you bothering me? Let me play my game. Let me mind my business."
10th grade.
Jay, and Ratchet. And Ratchet.
No, I wasn't in a 10th grade when San Andreas came out.
Ratchet.
You 15. Wait, you 15. You in 10th grade, y'all. Unless you slow as hell and stay back.
What?
Hold up.
I think I was 14, 15.
Ratchet.
Oh, you in 9th grade. You 14.
Ratchet, we were sitting here playing. Am I? Ratchet, we were sitting here playing Reach Halo 4, but I wanted to reach into some bitch's cheeks. Just because I was a gamer don't mean I want to do what I was doing to seeing them feet.
It's that kind of, I didn't lose my V card until I was 17, bro. And I lost it to my first actual girlfriend on some weird shit.
What picture are you, you talking about?
I really told you that, bro.
Yeah, I didn't even know she wanted to do anything, bro. Bro, you ain't never Butter. You ain't ever sit there and you be chilling at your house and you like you been so used to beating your meat that you beat your meat on a regular basis. And then she had called me over. She called me over that one day when I lost my virginity. I just got done beating the fuck out my meat before I went over there. And I was under the impression she just wanted to watch. I thought she wanted to watch like Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends or some shit. She talking to my legs.
You a crowd.
And she was like, "What you trying to do?" she answered the door dead ass butt naked, bro. It wouldn't get up for shit. My boy wouldn't get up for nothing.
Yo, ratchet. Let me let you in on the story, young nigga, young buck, young jock.
I'm like, my dick works better any other time.
I can't relate to you.